I'm Priya. I hope you are at safe at your places. Today we are going to learn some of the really very interesting rules of African festivals. And in our previous videos also we learned some of the very good things. If you haven't watched yet, just go and watch it. Okay, so let's get started with today's topic. See, what do we actually mean by saying African festivals? See, general rule for a sentence for active voice is subject, then verb, then object. Yeah, helping verb is always there, but that is according to the tenses, right? And when we talk about converting an active voice into passive voice, it all gets reversed, okay? So we all have to keep this in our mind. So let's get started. See, there are a lot of conditions of active voice and passive voice in the conversion according to the tenses. If the tense is indefinite tense or we can say simple tense, then there are certain rules. For simple present, we say the active voice, the rule for active voice is subject plus verbs first form plus object. Here I am not mentioning that SOES, I am not going in the detailed version. This is the general rule, okay? So what we need to do is we have to reverse it. The object is here at the last. We have to put it at the very beginning in the passive voice. So object plus is, am, are. Okay, if the active voice is in simple present, we have to put is, am, are, the helping verbs of continuous tense. Okay, then the verb third form, and this is main degree verbs third form and by. Then the subject, we have replaced subject with the object and object with the subject. I hope this is clear. And the same thing goes with the simple past as well and simple future as well. If I'm talking about simple past, the general rule is, again, subject, verb, second form, then object. So what do we need to do? We have to put the helping verb of past continuous tense, okay? Object plus was a verb plus verb's third form by plus subject. These two things are main entry, okay? If you're talking about simple future, from shall or will, this will be converted into shall or will be, then the verb's third form by, then the subject. For instance, here we go with some of the examples. For the first one, for the simple present, we say, for the simple past, the second one actually, we say the gatekeeper refused him. The gatekeeper, subject, refused, verb's second form, him, objective part, right? Active voice. Here we need to convert it into passive voice. So what we are going to do is, he was refused by the gatekeeper. When we talk about the same sentence in simple present or simple future, the thing goes the same way. The gatekeeper refuses him. He is refused. Here we have used is. Why? Because it is simple present. Got it? He is refused by the gatekeeper. Now the next one says the gatekeeper will refuse him. This is future one, right? Future, simple future. Now, what we are going to do, we will be adding will be, okay? So, he will be refused by the gatekeeper. Always know one thing, when the active voice is in simple tense or indefinite tense, we have to put the helping verbs of the continuous tense, okay? So, know this. So, I hope today's topic is clear to all of you. We will learn the other rules of other tenses in my next video in the next part. Okay, till then, please take care of you guys. Be safe, be reflexive, and keep practicing.